to Elected, Episode 3. I'm your host, Luke Radel. Now, in the age of 2017, social media, TV, magazines, and more are everywhere.
Well, she was holding one of those little bombs.
A bomb? You mean like one of these?
Ah, get it away, Steven!
And with these technologies are people's opinions. And it feels as though people will agree with these opinions as long as they line up with their ideology. But the question that comes into play is it true or is it fake news?
Read to me again from the list of my accomplishments.
Of course, sir. Nominated Neil Gorsuch.
God, I love that list.
Now, normally, you think of right-wing crazy conspiracy theorists like InfoWars' Alex Jones or Sean Hannity when you think about crazy false stories.
This is a human! This is what we look like! This is what we act like!
But if you look, you'll find that it's just the same on MSNBC's Rachel Maddow and CNN's Don Lemon, both very, very liberal.
Nor are we fake. Pinch me, I'm real.
But is it really fake news? According to President Trump, it seems as though anything against him, any news or headlines against him or his ideas, are fake news. While errors are made in big organizations like NBC, New York Times, or Washington Post, it is more likely to find false stories on small propaganda websites or small propaganda Facebook pages that just spread and go viral. Overall, the mainstream media has a major influence on our political system. What do you think? Should they put their opinions in their stories, or should they just, you know, tell the news? Let me know.